Hi, beauties and curls. Welcome back. It's Melissa Q. As you can tell in the title, it is May Favorites. Let's jump right in. We are talking about favorites of beauty boxes, hair care, skin care, makeup. Let's jump right
Y'all know I was going to talk about this. This is my Dr. Bronner's. It is gone. It's in my empties, but it's also a favorite of May for me. This is the Dr. Bronner's 18-in-1 Hemp Rose Pure Castile. I talked about this in my grown and sexy empties. Yes, I did. I said it because I use this as a feminine wash and I use this as a body wash and to clean my brushes. This is like the all purpose product of all time. You talk about body and I mean, it goes from A to Z. I absolutely love this and I have been loving this. I got this from an Ipsy. I received this from Generation Beauty. It was in my swag bag. This is the Organics Beauty Pure and Simple. This is the Fade Defying Orchid Oil. This smells so amazing. Oh my goodness. It actually is a color protect oil with UVA and UVB sun filters. It has grapeseed oil in it. And grapeseed oil, I don't know if you guys know this, but it has an amazing smoke point, which means that it's actually a heat protectant as well. So if you are blow drying your hair, if you are using a flat iron or a hair curler, this is the type of oil that you want to use. It is so good. It smells so good and it gives amazing shine. But it smells like flowers. Like if you do not like floral scents, this is not for you. Absolutely love this oil. So yeah. Do I have two of these? No. Anyway, I really like it. This is the Nip and Fab Dragon's Blood Fix Daily Cleansing Pads. This you can pick up from, I actually got mine from CVS, but I really do like these. Now I cleanse my skin. This actually gives it a glow. So it's almost like, it says it's a cleansing pad, but it's really a hydrating facial pad. So you wanna cleanse your face first, then use this because it has actually some hyaluronic acid. It helps plump the skin. This is something that you would use. To me, this is basically a pad with serum on it. So it would be after your cleanser, before your moisturizer, I would use one of these. I absolutely love these. These work like a high-end product. I really do enjoy this. You get 60 pads, so you can use it during the day and at night, so it lasts you for about 30 days. So I really do enjoy this. This is the Oyen Hairdo. As you can tell, I am out of this. This is the Daily Hair Quenching Lotion. This is one of my top moisturizers for my natural hair. The second ingredient in this product is castor seed oil. I really do enjoy it. It says it's lightweight, but don't put too much because you can go really heavy-handed really quick and your hair could be greasy because of the castor and olive oil and the coconut oil that's in here. It says it's lightweight, but those are like heavy oils to me. So you can, if you go a little crazy, you can like ruin everything, but just the right amount is so good. I can use this as my leave-in and my moisturizer. So I really, really do like this. I do have an 8 ounce, but this is the 16.9 ounce. This is the brand Minted Cosmetics. I love their products. This was sent to me, but I'm gonna come with a lip swatch video because these lipsticks are so creamy. They are so amazing. They're cruelty free and vegan. This is the shade Dope Taupe. It is so amazing. It is, all of the shades are like different shades of nude. I have 6 of these lipsticks. They are so good. I love the fact that it was designed that everyone could have their perfect nude. So I would say anybody could actually wear these lipsticks, but they are specifically designed for us that have issues, especially with women of color, have issues of trying to find that perfect nude. I highly recommend you checking them out, and I will leave a link down below because these are so good. Like I said, this is the shade Dope Taupe. I have worn a couple of their lipsticks on Instagram. I love Pretty in Pink. Nude La La is my favorite. Dope Taupe is a good one, and Dark Knight. I'm telling y'all, these are so good. These remind me so much of the NARS Audacious lipsticks that are like super creamy and long lasting. I am a classic lipstick girl. Okay, I love lip gloss. I love lipstick. These lipsticks are so good. They're long lasting. And I'm telling you, they give my Audacious lipsticks a run for their money. So I highly recommend you check these out. They are amazing. I have been loving, like, one of my favorite palettes right now is the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette. Lord, I love this palette. I know some people don't, but this palette is like the way to go for me. Next to the semi-sweet, the Sweet Peach is my second favorite. And I would say my third, which I'm going to talk about in a minute, is the Sugar Pop. I don't know if this one is still available. This one may have been limited edition, but this is the one that came out last year. You know, they always have like an, I feel like they have like a fall palette, a summer palette, a spring palette. Too Faced spits out palettes, okay? But I absolutely love this palette. My favorite shade is Summer Yum. This shade right here, y'all. This shade right up here. Summer Yum is the bomb, y'all. I love these shades. I just can come out with so many different looks. I do have a video already with two looks. I might come up with some more because I really do love these. I am a warm tone girl, but they do have some cool tone shades in here. I really do believe, you know, sometimes we talk about blendability, but we also need to remember that some of us have oily lids and have dry lids, and you have to put down a really good base, but it really does depend on that too, and it depends on your brushes. So I have totally enjoyed this. I really do love this palette. I can't take my hands off of it. Although it's in my rotation, yes, I have been loving it. Okay, so another palette that I'm absolutely loving is the e.l.f. Made for Matte. This is such an amazing palette. It makes me want to come with like my top 10 favorite palettes of all time. This one is so good. This is like probably one of my favorite palettes from the drugstore. This is all matte. I feel like to have a palette like this and then one with Papsa colors, you're good to go. This is something that you can definitely take and do a smoky eye and everyday look. You can do so many looks with this, and it has a black what? Y'all know how I feel about blacks and palette. Okay, another item that I have been loving. Kathleen Lights talked about this. This is the Fit Me Maybelline. This is their pressed powder. This is so good for under my eye. It brightens it up and it does not make my under eyes cakey, and it sets it where it does not crease. I am wearing it today. I absolutely love it. Does give my eyes, under eyes, that pop of color. I absolutely love it. I just love it, and it goes like a soft matte and gives that blurring effect. This is in 310. I really do enjoy this. Sun Beige 310. Yeah, that's the color that I am wearing. I really do enjoy this, and this is like one of my favorite under eye setting powders for my eyes lately. I really do love it. So the next items that I really have been enjoying, these are the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Pressed Powders. I kid you not, these are dupes to the MAC Mineralized Skin Finishes. These are so, so good. I did use it today. I did not wear any, I'm not wearing any foundation. I am wearing these pressed powders. And I just took a little bit of concealer. So I did my makeup look on YouTube Live. I did like my no foundation look there for you guys. I really do enjoy using these. I used this as my bronzer, and I use the Golden Tan for my my powder that I have on right now. This is like, you can go glam with no foundation, so don't be fooled. You do not have to have foundation on to go glam, as you can see that I did. But I really do enjoy these. I'm telling y'all, these are Mineralized Skin Finish dupes. I really do enjoy these. An OG love that I have been loving for years. This is the LA Girl Pro Conceal. This is in Pure Beige. This is the OG, y'all. OG concealer. It's full coverage. It's what I have on today. I really do enjoy this. You know how sometimes you go back to the OGs and you be like, that's why I love you. A couple of lip colors that I have been enjoying is the Lip Lingerie in the color Truffle. What is it called? Ruffle Trim. I really do enjoy this. It reminds me a lot of Anastasia's Ashton. I really do enjoy this shade. Let me swatch it for you guys. It's that reddish, like nude, like that reddish brown. If you don't know what to throw on, this is a shade that you would want to try and actually put. This is a shade that you would want to put on if you don't know what to put on. I've also been loving the Makeup Forever. This is their High Precision Lip Pencil in the number 14. I love these lip pencils. Makeup Forever is like one of my brands, my favorite brands of all time. I kid you not. I absolutely love this. Yes, yes, yes. And a new love of mine, this is the lip gloss Bare Naked by Laura Mercier. I think I got this in a favorite, what is it, the Give Me Some Lip. You know, they always have the Sephora favorites, Give Me Some Lip. This was in it, and this is Bare Naked. This is such a beautiful shade. This is the topper of all toppers to me. It beats my NARS Turkish Delight. I just love this shade just because it gives a sheer wash of color, but it let me show you. I'm just going to put it on top of that liquid lipstick. It does not really change the color that's under it, but it gives it a sheen. If you can look at that, it is so beautiful. I love this. It looks amazing with a liner. If you just wanted your lips to look bare, but like something there, this is the shade for you. Y'all know I'm a classic lip gloss lipstick girl, so I am loving that shade. I can't like put it down. I actually go through my purse to find that shade. I kid you not. I love it. Y'all know I give away a Ipsy Glam Bag every time I do a favorites video, so don't forget to enter down below. And yeah, let's get into the beauty boxes. I usually start off with BoxyCharm. Let's start off with Sephora today. So this is the Sephora box. This one is not open because I have used this before and it's amazing. And it is the Kate Summerfield Exfoliate. I love this. I love this. I love this. This is like one of the best exfoliators for your skin. It's pretty expensive. Kate Summerfield is not cheap. And Sephora, if it's in Sephora, most of the time it's not cheap either. So I absolutely love this. It is an, a great, this gives you baby skin like the first time you use it. I kid you not. I really do love this. And that's the reason why I didn't open it, is because I love to use these for, I love to use these either as giveaways for you guys or for travel, because most of these are travel size. So I really, really, really do enjoy this. I feel like Sephora has kind of set me up to take my money. Okay, when it comes to these play boxes, because they put the best things in here. This is the Peter Thomas Roth. This is the Water Drenched Hyaluronic Cloud Cream. If you have dry skin, if you love Peter Thomas Roth, pick this up. This is so good. Hydration for up to 72 hours. I don't know if I had hydration for 72 hours. I don't know about that claim. But this stuff is pretty amazing. It has hyaluronic acid in it. It has that clear. Now, I'm going to tell you something. This is one of the things that I love about this. It's water drenched. So someone with dry skin that is very parched would love something like this. It really doesn't have a scent. So if you are sensitive scents, if you have sensitive skin, this may be a product for you because it doesn't have a scent. But my oily girls are going to love something like this, because it says it's a cream, but it's actually kind of like a gel. It says it's water drenched. It's a hyaluronic cloud cream. Cloud meaning like, I don't know if they're talking about the shade or what it does, but it is super duper light. This is something ideal for spring and summer. I really do enjoy this. I can't talk enough about it. How many times are we going to talk about this in beauty boxes, right? This is the Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer. This was in my last month's BoxyCharm. This is a great foundation primer, something to smooth the skin out. Oily girls, I don't know if you'll like this. Dry girls, you probably would like this or the hydration one, but I really do enjoy this. I did not open this because I already have one open, but I really do like the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. Okay, I didn't get a chance to try this, but this is the Sephora Waterproof Eye Makeup Remover. I'm going to try this tonight because I can't believe that I skipped and like missed out on using this. So it says it has corn flour extract. I don't know what that means, but Sephora is being slept on by many of us because we, I don't know why we want to go to all the other brands, but I do believe that a lot of YouTubers are getting on the bandwagon and trying a lot of the Sephora products, so I'm excited about that. So that's what was in my Sephora play. Let's move on to BoxyCharm. I did put up the FabFitFun box as well as the Pinch Me box. I will let you check those out over here. Spring edition. I really do enjoy those boxes. So those will be added to the pile when they come up because both of those I think are kind of seasonal. The Pinch Me, every now and then I'll get stuff. If I have an influencer, maybe I'll put those in. Y'all let me know. But let's go ahead and go over to BoxyCharm. The first thing I'm going to pull out is something that I love. Let me pull out the things that I love and then let's talk about the wah-wahs. Okay, let's talk about the wonkies at the end. This is the Ofra Rodeo Drive highlighter. Now y'all know I love the Beverly Hills. The Rodeo Drive is this almost reminds me of the Estee Lauder Heat Wave. Does this not remind you of that? This is like universe, like if you want to, like if you're on a spaceship, they're going to see you from Earth with this one on. It is so beautiful. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. I love this highlighter. It is also amazing as an eyeshadow. Put some Fix Plus on it. It has so much pigment, you really don't have to do this, but these are great. Ofra highlighters are the business, y'all. I absolutely love this. It retails for $35. I don't know if you guys know it, but Ofra is now in Ulta. I'm so excited. Ulta is giving Sephora a run for his money. Like, I keep toggling and running back and forth, trying to figure out where I want to go. And I love both of them. But Ofra is now at Sephora. You can also check out, and there's discount codes everywhere. You can check those out to get that on discount, but it retails for $35 in my BoxyCharm that I only paid $21 for. So this already makes up for the price that I paid for this box. So winner, winning. Amazing in this box. This is a lip gloss from Cargo. This is in Umbria, the shade. And y'all, I'm telling y'all, this reminds me a lot of NARS Super Vixen, which I already have. I'm gonna see if it's a dupe, but I love this gloss because it is not sticky. I really, really do enjoy this gloss. It has a nice, it smells like cocoa. Did I get some on my nose? Okay, no. It smells like cocoa. It makes me kind of like want to take this lip gloss off and put it on. But I really do enjoy this lip gloss. I'm trying to find mine. I really do enjoy this lip gloss. It's not sticky. It is high gloss, high shine. I really, really, really enjoy that. And it makes me want, after I run out of this, I probably will get this again. This kind of reminds me of Anastasia Gilded too. It might be a little bit more gold. This one is a little bit more bronzy, but I love it. Okay, let's talk about the product that I haven't tried because I have the deep conditioner that I need to try with this. This is the Project Beauty Hairgurt Strawberry Banana Smoothing Yogurt Shampoo. I have the deep conditioner as well, and it says it helps tame unruly, frizzy, dry hair. So we will see. And we will come back. I just don't like, I like to pair them. And I'm so glad a lot of times BoxyCharm in 1 month will have something. And then the next month or the month after that, they will have something that's comparable to that. So I'm really excited about this hair product. Hopefully it will work for me. Y'all know I'm going to give y'all the 411 on that though. And let's talk about the, let me talk about the maybe and then let's talk about the oh no. Okay. These pure sponges, these are okay. It's okay. It's not the best at all, but it's not the absolutely worst sponge ever that I've tried. But these, it's kind of hard right now, but this one I use, I can say that these are pretty easy to clean. This is the one that I use versus the other ones. These are not ones that I'm just gonna like throw, give away or throw away, but Pure, the sponge that I got from Gen Beauty, this is not the same type of sponge. These are a lot harder. And the one that I got from Gen Beauty was a lot, it was very much comparable to the original Beauty Blender. These are okay for the beauty. This is okay. I feel like, you know what? It's good. You were in the BoxyCharm, but you didn't, you changed something, Pure. You changed something. So, yes, go back. Baby, come back. Yes. So, these are okay. I did like them, but not as good as the one that I had before. Okay, let's talk about the Oh No in here. I am forgetting to let y'all know how much stuff is. The lip gloss, the Cargo lip gloss, retails for $16. I'm forgetting something. Oh, the contour blending sponges. These retail for $36. I don't know if it's, these are not worth $36. I wouldn't have gotten these for $36. That means that they are $12 each. I wouldn't have paid $12 for one of these sponges. I would have just gone and got my Real Techniques for like, what is that? $6? $9 maybe? Under $10. Yeah. Real Techniques is better than that. Let's see. The Hair Girt, it retails for $10. That's pretty affordable for that shampoo to me. And the concealer palette. This one I did not like. And this retails for $19.99. Y'all, this was, oh no. Like, I'm decluttering this and I don't even want to give it to anybody. It is super waxy. It picks up the product when you lay it down on your face. I use it with a brush. I tried it with a beauty blender. I feel like that these wells right here are a bit small, but I think it's designed not to put your brush in. I mean, not to put your finger in, but your brush. I do like the fact that these are named like different flavors, like cream, ivory, vanilla, ginger, chocolate, toffee. That's pretty much the best thing from this palette. This is from Measurable Difference. I did not like this at all. The pigmentation was not good. And like I said, when you laid it down, it picked right back up. It did not go on opaque. And it was just, it skipped. So this was, oh no, 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 no. But compared to the ones that I have tried and the sponges being okay, I'm still satisfied with my BoxyCharm. I feel like in the battle, BoxyCharm lost the battle in these battle of the beauty boxes. Let's move on to Ipsy. Now I'm giving away an Ipsy bag. So yes, y'all, they put the Jessie Girl in here. I want to do if this is a dupe to the Kat Von D. So I'm really excited about this. It did go on very black. I did like this. Is it a dupe to the Kat Von D? I still like my Kat Von D. This did not make me want to like, not yet. Not yet. And I have been using this month, or last month rather. Jessie Girl, it's a good liquid eyeliner. It gave me that flexibility. I would say in terms of like how easy it is to use this. Yes, it is good like my Kat Von D. But it still makes me, I still would buy Kat Von D over this. I mean, that's just my preference. I don't see, not yet, I don't see the difference yet. And my eye kind of ran a little bit. I got kind of watery. So I don't know if it was this pen or if it was my like mascara or if it was just the day. But as far as when I have worn this, and this one fades a little bit quicker to me. The Kat Von D lasts all day and it dries matte. This one kind of faded a little bit. I don't know. That was just me. Maybe that's just me. Maybe I need to set it. But that's an extra step that I don't have to do with my Kat Von D. So I do like this though. I like this pen. I think it's worth the $6 that you pay for it. So yeah, the next thing is this Lisa Frank. Oh, this is so cute. It has unicorns on it. Everybody's in the unicorn rave. I like unicorns, y'all. Some people, I like unicorns and fairies. Yes, I like Peter Pan. I like Legend. Those are like one of my favorite movies. Yes, one of my favorite movies. The Legend, and not The Legend, but it's called Legend with Tom Cruise. Y'all remember that? And then also Peter Pan. Tinkerbell, I love fairies, okay? So I love this brush. It's super soft. I really did enjoy this. This is great for blush, or if you want to do a soft kind of like contour, or what I've been doing is taking a brush like this and putting my bronzer on it and kind of like bronzing contouring. This is the type of brush you want to use. I really did like this. I really enjoyed it. It's super cute and it's a little bit kiddish for me. But sometimes you need to come out with that inner kid. You know what I mean? Okay. This brush was so good with this. This is the Betty Luminizer. I cannot believe that I have not tried this before my MC Glam bag. This is a bronzing shadow. No, or you can use it as an eyeshadow. You can use it as a bronzer on your face. Anybody young, anyone darker than me would love this as a highlight, like a bronzy gold highlight. Anybody lighter than me would probably use this as a shimmering bronzer. But this is the shade here. I love this. I love this. I don't have on any right now, but it's making me want to put on some. I really do enjoy this. It makes me want to get the trio because I haven't tried the pink one either, but I really do enjoy this. So yeah, I talked about that too long. This is the It Cosmetics Superhero. This is one of my favorite mascaras. Yes, 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 Ipsy. And I'm telling y'all, the reason why I love everything in my Ipsy and not in sometimes my BoxyCharm, there have been a few things that I haven't liked in my Sephora Play, and I'm not playing this up. I kid you not, you guys. It's because I do the reviews and I tell them exactly, no, I don't like that. No, I don't like that brand. Yes, I like the brand, but I don't like the color. Yes, I like eyeliners, but I'm tired of black. So, you know, I can actually customize my glam bag. You get points. I really like that. You could get points with BoxyCharm too. I really do enjoy that part. But this is one of my favorite mascaras of all time, y'all. I love Superhero. It makes my eyelashes look false, okay? And I love these travel sizes. I don't know about you, but I kind of feel like the travel sizes are kind of like the best of, even they're even better than the large ones. Are y'all with me? Comment down below and let me know if you're with me on that. I feel like the wand can get all in the product. And sometimes I feel like the larger mascaras kind of stop at a certain point and there's still a product in the bottom. I don't know. That's just me in my head, okay? But I really do enjoy the Superhero. I love it. I love it. I love it. Okay, and the last item in here, I didn't get a chance to use. This is the No Problem Primer. It hides pores and wrinkles, and it's from Touch and Soul. I want to try this. 4 out of 5, though, I think that's pretty good for the Ipsy Glam bag. It's only 2 products that I didn't get a chance to try for the month. I feel like that's pretty good. Okay. So, that is it for my favorites, you guys. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to comment down below and let me know what you have been loving this month. Yes. And don't forget to enter the Ipsy Glam Bag giveaway. I am giving away one of these, and I'm going to tell y'all, this month is really good. Not this month. The one that has this, the ticket, was a really good Ipsy Glam Bag. I mean, I usually always love my Ipsy Glam bags, but this one was pretty darn good. Yeah. And I love the versatility of like giving you something for your face, something for your eyes, like a bronzer. And I love it. And how cute is this? Okay. So amazing. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please subscribe if you hadn't already. I'll see beautiful you in the next video. Bye, lovies. Hi, beauties and curls. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. All you have to do is that face with the in the circle. Hit that over there and also check out my latest video that I'm going to put over here as well. Thanks so much for watching and I'll see beautiful you in the next video. Bye, lovies.